The workers that create for you, built that machine, were iron folders in Chicago. They took the lead on the 8-hour work day. There was a slogan: 8 hours work, 8 hours rest, 8 hours play. Today we talk about the issue of police violence and the killing of unarmed African Americans, Latinos, and others by the police. That same history is tied into Mayday. The police, which is loyal and provides the rules squad for the ruling class, that's why conditions create outcomes. the disabled. They were empowered by that victory. And that's what spurred them on to do the struggle for the 8-hour workday.
Campaign for Bernie Sanders.
of women in the 1820s who worked in the hills, places like Massachusetts, with long hours in the textile mills when they were Sabbath there, producing the cloth and clothing made by the cotton that slaves did in this country. Not knowing, and perhaps We got to stop being bystanders. Just stand by. his position on stopping corporate greed. So although he's not here today, he has sent me a letter that I will now ask Brother Sean Graham to read to you. Thank you.
All right, this is a letter from the attorney. He apologized for that, but he didn't. They listen. Imhotep the architect. State building. I'm on my Benjamin Banneker, Louis A. Slatimer, giving them light, the reason they mad at us. They prefer in the shadow while we shining immaculate. Green with envy, cause they can't manufacture it. Got the African continent on my amulet feet. Color of burnt brass like Jesus of Nazareth. Every revolution needing a catalyst. From the passages, a spook who sat by the door, the protagonist. I'm moving like I'm Sam Green, Legion. Green petite while these Uncle Tom Curtis sipping their green tea. In these mean streets, the beast just wanna feast. He just pulled up his seat, unfolded his handkerchief. It's like generous serve, Monsieur Bon Appetit. The judges, the police, the government on the sneak. The saga never ceased, the cycle on repeat. The torch was passed to me. I'm trying to carry on tradition for all my peoples to be free. Power to the people.
Thank you, Brother Tyson.
Listen, but guess what? The city of Stockton came out of bankrupt. But guess what? We still out here marching. We still out here shutting and knocking at their doors. I have a date now, because I didn't give up. I have the date now, because I didn't give up. So I'm going to let my husband talk, but I want to let y'all know that this fight is real. This fight is so real, it could be you next. Someone you know will be killed by the police. You know, I always say this, Logan, every time I go to these cities and go be able to talk. Today my family, tomorrow be your family. We just had a killing in Stockton 2 weeks ago. Raleigh Watts was shot and killed in Stockton by the Stockton police. Shot him in his head. We just put him to rest Wednesday. So we have an event in Stockton for 2 days in advance. We would like y'all to come out and support us. I have flyers to pass out of anyone, and we can also give you rides if you need a ride to Stockton. But this fight is real. We need y'all support. And I always say a mother's cry. We got to fight for the kids that have been put in the system. They're being abused, and they also have been killed by police. And they have no voice. So we also have to be their voice. We got to be the voice for the parents that's in incarceration. That kids out here being shot and killed also. We need to be that voice. So my husband's going to finish, and thank you.
All right, girl.
Pretty much covered it all. I think she speaks from the heart. She's made media contact with your mothers all over the country. Not just here on the West Coast, but she's been in many places, Ferguson and Cleveland. She's been all over with joining with them families because the fight ain't just in our backyard, you know? And sometimes we got to get out and we got to go support them families like Oscar Grant, Stephen Johnson was saying. When Oscar Grant was killed, you know, we didn't know that our son would be killed the next year. He was killed in 09, New Year's. And we took a stand on his first... The first thing they did on the platform here in Fruitvale, we stood up there and we spoke about how severe that is when somebody gets killed like that, and especially when they're unarmed. But then our son got killed in 2010, so it kind of reminded us when Oscar Grant got killed. You know what I'm saying? The same feelings popped up. But just back to what she was saying, that, you know, we need a lot of unity, especially with our young people on the street. We have really got to come together and stop being so jealous of the next person, stop being so envious of the next person, and love that person. Because I ain't got it, let me get with somebody that might have it, because I might get it. But saying that because he got it, I ain't got it, I want to take it from him or do something to him and get it. That's not right. So we have to put these guns down and put our hearts up in front of us, man, because we are dying at a rate that we cannot come back from. The people that are gone are not here no more. They're not here, but we are still here. So we can make that change. And that change comes from being more utilized, being more together with each other. You know what I mean? It's hard when you got to do it by yourself, man. It really is. And just to see when my son was killed like that, you wouldn't want to see the more pictures, man. Just seeing the more pictures make you say, hey, I don't want that to happen to my friend. He was shot 48 times with an AR-15 in the back of his head. He was only 16 years old, a day before his 17th birthday. That was 6 years ago, and we still standing today because it has not stopped. It has not stopped. So we appreciate you guys being out here, and we love it, man. This is what we need. We need to do it more. Thank you.
That was the family of James Revere, 16 years old, killed in Stockton.
Washington police. This next family.
Carrying that gun. Everyone talks about this gun control stuff, and I think we need to control them and their guns sometimes. You know, they talk about all their professional training, yet they go and kill my son on September 14th, 2014. He's unarmed, walking at the store, and they pull him to the side, detain him, and give him a hard time, and next thing you know, they stole his life from him and from me and my wife and his grandparents. And I'd like to thank the James Rivera family for being so strong. It helps me be strong and fight for this, and Uncle Bobby here for being so strong. We're fighting for, we are getting somewhere in the city of Richmond. We are getting independent investigation by the Citizens Review Commission. We got them to change the name of the police commission to the Citizens Review Commission because they're here for the citizens and not for the police. We got to sharpen the teeth of the police, the Citizens Review Commission, so they can make some better recommendations and stuff. They're going to investigate Dee's case, my son's case, and they're also going to start investigating every case that comes up with a person being shot in the city of Richmond and with a great bodily harm. Those kind of cases are going to be investigated every time. It's because, you know, we have to be persistent and keep fighting for these guys. You know, nothing's going to bring my son back. There's only one person I know that rise from the dead, and my son was a lot like him, but anyway, he's up there with him now. And